Hi there. Well, I'm starting a four-part series, and it's going to make some of you very glad, and maybe some of you that are watching for this very first clip, you might even be agitated by the very title that I've chosen, because it is called, Did You Know That God Loves Prosperity? And you know, I meet people all over the world as I'm around Christian circles that actually believe that God is against prosperity. They believe that he would prefer that we would be poor, and that in our poverty we would be called humble, and that humility or that type of humility would please him. And I think that there's a gross misrepresenting of the person of God and of the very nature of God as we think that way. And so I want to unpack this for you and help you lay hold of the prosperity that God has for your life and for my life and for all of his children in the kingdom of God, because we are in a prosperity covenant with the Lord God Almighty. And when you start seeing this within the scripture, you're going to be so excited. I think one of the things that the enemy used to put a wedge into people's understanding was during a season when God was highlighting his biblical prosperity, there was a movement called the faith movement or the prosperity movement. There are actually two different components, because God was calling his people to believe the word. That was the word of faith movement as it came to be known. Like any movement, there are the extremes and the things that go overboard in it, where the flesh manifests, where things go outside of the perimeters of the word and the nature of God. And you'll find that in any move of the Holy Spirit. But I believe that God was truly highlighting his word, his promises, his covenant, and asking us to believe his word and to stand on that word in that way. Inside that movement, there was a call for the church, for the body of Christ, to stand in the prosperity promises of the word of God. And as people did that, prosperity was coming to them. It was attracted to them, because whenever you stand on the word of God and believe it, your faith joined with the word of God acts as a magnet for what you're believing for. And so prosperity starts coming to you. The problem was that in some cases, people got very worldly minded and started loving money and the pleasures of the world rather than loving God. And there are warnings in the word of God regarding that we will look at in another session. Before we go there, though, I want to today help you unpack this whole nature of God and his heart concerning prosperity. Just because something was in excess in church history doesn't mean that we have to throw the baby out with the bathwater. And over the last number of years, as I've been ministering in different places, encouraging people to live in the fullness of what God has for them, I've been finding that many people judge the word faith movement and the prosperity movement in former days. And those ones that judge the prosperity movement, unfortunately, lock themselves into some warfare that has brought lack and oppression and restriction in the area of provision in their life. The reason being is because they made a judgment and then they were locked into that judgment. As I've helped them see what God has for them and that the judgment that they made was unwarranted, they would repent from the judgment that they had towards the movement and some of the ministries in that movement, and turned away from their attitude and turned unto God and started embracing the truth, then prosperity opened up upon them. Now, what I believe true biblical prosperity is to first of all have enough to extravagantly worship God, to give to him the first and the best, and we'll talk about that in another session. Secondly, that we have enough of material sustenance to meet our own needs, whatever those needs are. It is different for every person. And thirdly, always enough to help meet the needs of others, that we always live in an overflow. True biblical prosperity does not mean that you love mammon or love riches. It's not a worship of those things. It's not something that you live for. We live for God, but as we live for him, these things follow us and we can expect them, but we don't worship them. We don't put them as the priority within our life. It's interesting that I find that people that live in a lot of lack have a lot of focus on money and needs, and it's because they haven't learned to live in the rest of prosperity. When you live in the spirit of prosperity that I'm going to unpack for you, you will know how to embrace the promises for your life, and you start ministering out of rest and excitement and joy because you're expecting God to do great things. It's not about how much money is in your bank account. It's not about how much of the world you've got all over you and all of its glitter. It's about the testimony of the Lord that lives big within you because you've embraced the fullness of all that He has for you. So we've been finding that as people embrace true biblical prosperity, that they become extravagant worshipers of God with their material possessions. They have their own needs met to the full, and that there's an overflow that reaches out to bless the world around them and the people around them. And that's a wonderful way to live. It's a way without worry, without fear. Doesn't matter what the economy is doing, if it's up or down. It doesn't matter if you're employed or not employed. When you understand true biblical prosperity, you can live in the fullness of that peace all the time, no matter what's going on around you. And over the next few sessions, that's what I'm going to bring to your heart and life, because God has given me a scripture promise, very strong, especially for this year. And it's Deuteronomy 8:18. And it says that He is giving us the power to create wealth or to make wealth. And so we're going to look at that in another session. But I have a promise for this year, and I want to see the fullness of that promise manifest, where the heavens are open and the glory of God comes down to see every need met and an advancement of the kingdom like never before. Now, I want to give you a definition right out of the dictionary. Here is some words that describe prosperity out of the dictionary. One of them is profitability. Do you know that the scripture says that God teaches us to profit? He teaches us to succeed. When we follow the word of God and its principles, we will profit. And so one of the meanings of prosperity is profitability. Another one is affluence. Another one is a good life. I've written a little book called The Good Life. It's a little study guide. You can order it online. It's a great little teaching on how you can set goals and how you can go for more than what you've got now. And you can live by the promises of God and have them activated within your life. And that's one of the definitions out of the dictionary to describe the word prosperity, living a good life. It also said in the dictionary, milk and honey. Isn't that amazing that God led Israel into a land of milk and honey? In other words, a land of prosperity. And God wants to lead you into a land of prosperity. He wants to lead you into an abundant place within your life. Jesus said that He came that we would have life, the good life, and have it in its abundance, like the milk and honey of life. That's what He wants for you. And this year, and even as you embrace this word, it can change everything for you as we see a shift take place in your life so that you can start moving into fullness. I have faith for that for you, and I'm going to pray for impartation in a few moments as well. It also means luxury. Do you know that God is an extravagant God? If you look at the way that He created the life around you, the trees, the blossoms, the flowers, the fish in the ocean, everything around you, if you study creation, it's extravagant. It's luxurious. If you read in your Bible what heaven is like, you'll find it's full of gemstones and crystal seas and sapphires and light and brilliance and beauty. Everything about God is so luxurious and extravagant. And that is one of the definitions of prosperity. And He wants to lavish you with that goodness. He wants you to have the fullness of everything that He has for you. And also, comfort. It means comfort. Do you like to be comforted in times of trial? Do you know that in the earthly realm, we can have many things that discomfort us, but in the heavenlies, there's comfort. There's comfort. 100% comfort, 100% well-being. That's what prosperity is all about. And you can be comforted right now in whatever affliction is trying to strike at you. Because when you embrace prosperity, when you embrace the force and the essence of kingdom prosperity that God loves and how He loves to give it to you, you will have comfort. It also means security. When you are living in prosperity, you have security. Why? Because in God's extravagance, He supplies for us protectors and angelic forces around us, and His very presence that keeps us strong. And it also means plenty. Do you know that one of the names of God is